moving on through, specifically this last one that hit, very noticeable because we had that bombogenesis.
I dropped it.
I mean, the pressure, really impressive. Yeah. 943 millibars. When we talk about intense drop in pressure, that shows you that the storm is rapidly intensifying. That's when we get the highest rain totals and the highest snow totals and also the most intense wind.
And so if you're not a meteorologist and you're thinking that we're making up words, bombogenesis, what that is a real word. And what happens with storms is that means it dropped 24 millibars all in 24 hours. And if you're also wondering, millibars, what is that? That is how we measure the strength of storms. So similar to in inches, how we measure how tall something is or how small something is, that's exactly how we measure storms. And with this storm in particular, you know, the big concern I have with this system is just all of that rain that has been falling across parts of the West. You know, Britta, last week, you know, in rehearsals, we were talking all about the fact that this was an area where we saw quite a bit of drought, and now it seems like the complete opposite is happening.
Exactly, a little bit of feast or famine. So it is good news to have all that intense moisture, but the issue is we're getting a lot in a short amount of time, so that's a concern in terms of flooding. Also, we have burn scars. So if you live by anywhere that had been dealing with wildfire, and at one point over the summer, we were tracking well over 75, 80 active wildfires, those all left scarred soil with no vegetation, and we cannot handle that intense rain, and then you start to get mudslides and debris flows. So although we are happy to see the rain, happy to see the higher elevation snow, you do need to be very careful in those burn scar areas and also the areas that are just getting too much in too short of a time frame. Yeah.
And if you've never heard of burn scars, basically what that is, the land or plants, it burns, and then when it rains, it has no place to go. It starts to run off, and that's where you start to get that increasing risk of not only some landslides, but also a bit of that flash flooding.